I come in the name of the Master, Yahushua HaMashiach, as I stand before Almighty Yah, in a place I haven't stood for a season. And I give the Father praise for giving me the strength to stand here today. But I still admonish you to pray for me.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Now, I got to do something the Father hasn't liked me to do. I don't know how it's going to come out. But I just want to tell Brother Johnson that this morning he preached all over my message. Yeah, he just walked all in there.
Wow.
So if y'all hear a verse or two that sounded like what he preached this morning, that's the Father's business.
So
but this is what I have to do right now. When I went out on a limb and did the best I can, my Father gave me strength to stand up and be a man. Because I trust and obey. When I lay my head at night upon his breast and I pass all of today's tremendous test, it's because I trust and obey. When I've seen life to its farthest extreme, and I feel that in my life, there is nothing that seems real. But when I hold my head up and see his face, I feel that I'm in his abundant grace. Because I trust and obey. And that's it. I prayed to the Father. I said, Father, I need a word for you people. I do that all the time. Because I don't want to come before you with what I think. How I feel about it. I want to share with you what the Father gave to me.
Yes.
I also want to thank the Father. I heard Brother Ben this morning for the first time in his ministry on the radio, on the telephone line. And the brother did a beautiful job.
Hallelujah.
And the thing about it, he's talking to people who don't believe like us. But if you hear him, he sounds like he talked to people that believe just like us. Because he don't hold nothing back. And they still want more. So I thank the Father for Brother Benjamin's ministry.
Yeah.
And if you get a chance to wake up at 1 o'clock in the morning, you can hear. Because see, the Father didn't let me lose until about 11:30, quarter to 12, in the message that he gave to me. Not this one, another one. But the Father just kept me going until about 11:30, quarter to 12. So when I got in bed, I was dog tired. But I prayed a prayer. I said, Father, if it's your will for me to hear Brother Benjamin, wake me up at 1 o'clock. My Father woke me up at 1 o'clock. So it was meant for me to hear his word this morning. Hallelujah. I don't know who phone that is, but heaven must be calling. Somebody better answer. The Father has blessed us. And we who are blessed need to hear this message today. Do we have any worshipers in the house?
Hallelujah!
Yes.
Now that sounds good. But be mindful, you might get your toes stepped on today. I want somebody to go to John chapter 4. You don't have to stand up right now, but if you want to stand up, that's fine. Because the assembly that the Messiah built, most people stood up during the message being taught.
Yeah.
The whole message. Except for that three-day message that he preached out there, people did lay on the ground a little bit, I guess so, because they weren't eating and they were tired. Somebody who got it, read John chapter 4, verse number 24.
Almighty God is spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth.
Okay, thank you. You all may be seated. That's the beginning of the message right there.
Yeah.
First mention is the technique I use for any word that I have to define scripturally. Wherever that word is first mentioned, that's the definition I'll use. So in the first mention, we're looking at the word shakar. That's the word for worship, shakar. It means to depress. That is, to prostrate oneself as if giving homage to royalty to the Almighty God. Bowing yourself down, to crouch, to fall down flat, humbly beseeching him, do make obeisance to him, do reverence him, and to make one stoop. Now, unfortunately, a lot of folks, you can go to many, many assemblies or churches as they're so-called today, but you won't find too many people bowing for him. You won't find too many people that's willing to get on their knees before him, humbling themselves, giving obeisance to him. Because the problem is we've made ourselves more God than our Heavenly Father to be worshipped. We got to get beside ourselves to give him true worship. That's why the scripture says he seeks for those who will worship him in spirit and in the truth. I can't understand how people can sit down and listen at an hour, hour and a half, sometimes 2 hours, a half hour of the Father's word and don't want to fall down before him to give him honor. I can speak just one word right now that all of us need to bow down and thank him. He woke you up this morning. That should humble every one of our hearts in here because so many people didn't wake up. Some woke up and couldn't get up. Some woke up and couldn't see. Some woke up and couldn't hear. Couldn't talk. But look at us. We have all of these blessings poured upon us this morning. And we should bow down and worship him. Why? Because he is worthy. The word worship in this context is three letters. It's the Shin, the Het, and the Hey. These three letters represent something. The Shin represents a pressing, like two teeth and sharp and being able to eat. And the Het is divide outside or half. It's similar to a tent wall. And the word Hey is to look, reveal, breath, and man with arms raised. Just those three letters tell you that to worship means more than just sitting down.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We find that if we take those words and put them into a sequence, this is what it says. When the pressing comes into your life and you begin to feel as though you are at the outside looking in, it is then that you will look to the one that is revealed to you with your arms raised and worship him and him alone.
Hallelujah.
All of that in three letters. And we missed it for so long because some people knew that but wouldn't teach that to us. We got to hear what the Father is expecting from us. He wants us to worship him. You know, it's a sour thing in my spirit that he has to look, search for somebody to worship him. Out of so many billions of people on this planet, he has to search. And we call ourselves a Christian nation. That's one of the biggest lies ever told. You got more evil going on in this country than you can shake a stick at. And they're trying to make it sweet. No. We got to get this thing down, and we got to get it down according to scripture, or else we will fall into the same rut that everybody else is in. I'm not saying we're better than anybody. I'm not saying we know more than anybody. This book called the scriptures is there for everybody. But that's why the Father said, Brother Blackwell, in the last day I'm going to raise up ministers after my own heart, who will teach my people. Stop procrastinating and putting it off and telling my people are not ready for this. People are ready for whatever you teach them.
Hallelujah.
I'm looking at Sister Kim. She got three little ones with her. Hallelujah. My brother over here got one love with him. And those three are going to do what they are taught to do. Yeah. We were taught to live the certain lifestyle that we are living right now. Yeah. Hallelujah. Some of us went a long ways from the teachings that our parents gave us because we wanted to see what the world was like.
That's right.
And then we found out it wasn't all that.
No, it's not.
And we hurried up and turned around and came back. Now we're looking for the truth because we don't want to even go back to where we were.
Right.
We want to go where the Father wants us to be.
Yes, yes.
The word prostrate yourself means to give homage to royalty and to Almighty God, to bow down, to crouch yourself, to fall down, to humbly beseech him, to do obeisance before him, to reverence him, to make yourself stoop. And all of that is called worship. But unfortunately, we weren't taught that. We thought sitting in the church house, oh, we go and worship the Father and don't do anything like worship. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Some people don't even want to come. They just come to satisfy a quotient, a time, an element of time to say, I went to church.
Yeah.
But when you have a heart for Almighty God, you want to be in the assemblies of Almighty God so you can learn more about him, that your faith can be increased. Because faith comes by hearing the word of Almighty God. Every time the door is open where there's teaching going on, you ought to be there.
Hallelujah.
With your book, with your pencil, with your paper, even with your microphone. I sit in here sometimes and I record because I know I can't remember everything said. It's important to me not to miss a word. Because the scripture says man shall live by, not by bread alone, but by
every word.
Are you taking this thing seriously enough to be called a worshiper? Are you really? How many times have a sinner seen you bow down? Because if you don't show them that day you need to bow down, they won't bow down. You say you're a slave to the Most High. Now what are you portraying to them? Well, Brother Anderson, I'm getting quiet on you right now. Maybe I'm listening and maybe I'm just getting upset because you stepped on a toe. I told you. I hope you wore your steel toes this morning. We're going to start off in the book of Matthew. That's Matthew chapter 15. Come on, go with me, because I know some of y'all might be hungry for the food, but I'm going to give you some food from the word.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Matthew 15. Looking at verse 8. He said, "This people draw near unto me with their mouth. And they honor me." See, he didn't deny the fact that they honor him. He said, "They honor me with their lips. But their heart is far from me. But in vain they do worship me." What did he say? "In vain they do worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men." Y'all hear that? Now I can stay right there on that one verse for a good while. Because that's what's going on in the so-called church world today.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, Brother Blackwell quotes the scripture often enough. He said, "You come as my people. You sit before me as my people. You look like my people, but you won't do what I command you to do."
Come on now.
The more I bless you, the more you curse me.
Come on now.
And you know the Father has done a lot for us.
Hallelujah.
Can somebody say hallelujah on that?
Hallelujah.